Hey, I am Vedant, and it's time for some DIY. Why? 'Cause I love it.
What up, guys? Welcome to Mad Stuff with Rob. I am Rob, and I'm back with another fun DIY. Now, before I start the DIY, I want to take this moment to thank you guys for the love and for the support. Guys, we have crossed 125,000 subscribers and it's still growing, which is insane. It's crazy. Oh, okay, please, stop it. I'm loving this, guys. If you've been following me on Instagram and Snapchat, you will see that the last 2 weeks were really crazy, really busy. I was in Goa, then in Bangalore. I was shooting some really interesting videos, met some really fun artists. I will be sharing the videos very soon. Also, you send a lot of comments and requests. I'm really sorry that I've not been able to sit down and reply to all the comments, but I'm going to do that very soon. But today, right here, right now, I will be fulfilling one of the requests. And this you can set in stone. That's right. So get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? You know it. So let's get started. So as you know, we are making cement hand planters. So for that, we need our material. So I have cement here, which I haven't used in a while. So I'm very happy and excited. Now this is your regular cement. You can get it at any hardware store. Now we'll take some water and we'll add in this. Keep adding little water at a time and keep mixing. We don't want any lumps, so make sure you mix it well. And then when you have this porridge or peanut butter like consistency, then you can stop. Now it's time to get the glove in. And you can see these are kitchen gloves. And now we are going to fill this up with cement. So I'm putting a couple of scoops in and then just shaking it so that it reaches every corner or every part of this glove. You can just squeeze it so that it goes in the fingers. And make sure you keep pinching so that there are no air bubbles. You won't be able to get rid of all the air bubbles, but at least there won't be any big ones. So just shake and pinch every time you put more cement in. Okay, so I'm happy with the amount of cement there is in this glove. So I'll get the cement out. And now we'll get another bowl in. And you can see I have put some newspaper in this. I've just crushed and rolled the newspaper to give it a slight base. Now we'll place this glove full of cement on it. And I'm pressing it to basically shift and transfer the cement in all the fingers here and also to get the desired shape. And to give it more shape, you can take some more newspaper and keep adding it in different places. And when you're happy with the desired shape, you can take a bowl or a glass and just place it right in the middle of the hand like that, press it down. So that you have a nice clean cavity or depression over there. And this is the place where you will add your plant later. So this way, this glove hand or cement hand will become a planter. There you go. I am very happy with how it looks. Now I will keep it aside for drying. Now this usually takes roughly 24 hours to dry, but it can take longer depending on the weather conditions or where you're placing it to dry. If there is more moisture, if it's cold, then it will take longer. So you need to keep it in a dry place or keep it in the sun so that it dries faster. Now to check, you need to basically, because this is cement, it'll harden, so you can just feel it and you'll know that it has hardened completely. Only then you can remove the bowl and you can cut the glove to take out your cement hand. So let's keep it aside and wait. And here you go, we have this hand ready. I let this set or cure for 24 hours. Let's check. Yes, it's nice and hard. So you can remove the bowl And now you can carefully lift the hand and take it out. So the bowl goes out and our cement hand is ready. As you can see, we have a nice depression, a cavity or space here where we can put our plants. And because it has hardened completely, it has retained the shape like how we placed it in the bowl. So it'll look really nice when we take it out of the glove. It'll look like hands holding a small plant. So let's carefully cut this glove. Make sure you do this process very carefully so that the hand doesn't break. And if it has dried completely, it'll be very easy to peel off the glove. And now with the help of a brush, you can just get all the dust and the smaller pieces out so that your surface is clean. All right, I think we are done. Looks pretty cool. It rests really nicely. It has a nice stable base. So now you can just put your plants right here in this cavity and your planter is ready. So let's get the plants in. So you see, I have some plants here and I've picked up these succulents because they are small. They don't require too much of water and too much of soil. Also, they are really tiny in size, so they are perfect for something like this. I think I will pick maybe this one. Yeah, fits like a glove. Perfect. So I'm going to just put some soil here. Plants like these, you can just go to any shop and pick from there. You have a whole range and variety. Otherwise, you can just step out and see if there are any plants in your neighborhood or garden and you want to plant those. You can just go get them and place it in your planter. And our cement hand planter is ready. And we are done. Our cement hand planter is now ready. Look at that. I think it looks pretty cool. What do you guys think? It's much better than your boring pots, right? This has some style. And I have done only one hand, but if you want, you can do more than one. Make two, make three, try different positions and styles. You know what I mean? Be creative, guys. And if you like it, then give me a hand in this position. A big thumbs up. Also, like, share, and subscribe to my channel. I keep telling you guys, it's free, so do it right now. And if you're making this, then don't forget to click pictures or shoot a video. Wait a minute, I should shoot a video. I'll put this on my Snapchat. DIY planter is now ready. We'll upload the video soon. There you go. That goes on my Snapchat. So if you're following me on Snapchat, Facebook, or Instagram, you will get all the updates. And if you're not, then what are you waiting for? The handles are down below. Just start following me right now. So like I was saying, if you make this, then click pictures and send them to me. You know how to get in touch with me, right? I'll see you in my next video. Until then, do good and be good. Peace.